What are you staring at, ugly? You want some of me?
I wasn't staring at you.
You're new around here, aren't you?
Yeah, gosh, I hate this town. All the kids are stupid and lame. What are you doing coming into this place?
Well, we came to see a magic trick.
We're visiting our friends. Mike and Joey?
The so-called magician and dummy?
Joey is not a dummy.
I was talking about Mike.
Abracadabra is a production of the West Virginia School of Osteopathic Medicine and its Healthy Children's Initiative. Additional funding for this program is provided by Charleston Area Medical Center, Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield West Virginia, West Virginia Mutual Insurance Company, and by the Brick Street Foundation.
Happen if you know how to say abracadabra, puts fun in every day. Mike and Joey and all their friends can fill every day with cheer. Abracadabra, all your friends are here.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Abracadabra. Oh, welcome, welcome. Joey, is this the please and thank you machine? Oh, yes, I'm trying to fix it so it's less testy. Oh, yes. You see, boys and girls, pat, meaning please and thank you, will magically produce anything that you ask for, as long as you say please when you ask for it, and thank you when you receive it.
That's right. Otherwise, watch out.
Yes, you could say that again. I remember where she dumped popcorn on my head and a pie in Nastini.
That's right. And that's why I'm trying to make it less testy, so she won't do that anymore.
Well, that's good.
And it's ready.
It's ready?
Yeah. Go ahead, try it out. Are you sure? Yeah, go ahead, try it.
Okay, I'll try it.
Hello, I'm Pat. What can I get you?
I'd like a glass of water, please.
Of course.
Wow, thank you.
You are most welcome.
That worked great.
Yes, I suppose that now you want me to try this without saying please?
That's right.
I don't know, Joey. In the past, she would have dumped that glass of water on my head.
No, that's not going to happen this time.
Are you sure?
Trust me, I'm an inventor.
Okay, here we go.
Hello, I'm Pat. How may I help you?
Give me a glass of water.
Don't you want to say please?
Joey, are you sure she's not going to dump water on me?
Oh, trust me.
Okay. No, just give me the water.
Okay.
Oh, Joey!
Well, at least he didn't dump it on your head.
Oh!
It's time to play the more or less game. Yeah! I'm going to show you two foods, and you're going to have to decide which one has more fat. Today's contestants are fried fish fillet and grilled salmon fillet. Which one has more fat? If you selected the fried fish fillet, you are correct. The fried fish fillet has 4 teaspoons of fat, and that isn't very healthy. The grilled salmon fillet only has 1 1/3 teaspoons of fat. If you choose foods with less fat, you'll always be a winner.
I can't wait for Mike to get here so we can see his new magic trick.
Magic tricks are for babies and dumb people like you. What are you laughing at, Kate? I wouldn't be caught dead in clothes like yours.
My clothes?
You're not very nice.
You're a bully.
You guys better get out of my sight. Now!
Come on, girls. We'd better go.
Oh, hi, girls. I was just going to do a magic trick.
That's dumb. Huh?
Hi. I don't believe we've met before. I'm Mike.
I'm Grace. I've heard you're the greatest magician in the world.
Oh, well, thank you. You don't know what's wrong with Kate and Emma and Morgan, do you? They left here crying and they ran out.
No clue. They just said something about not wanting to see another magic trick and left.
Very strange.
Can you do a magic trick just for me?
Oh, well, sure I can. See, I have something new here. I have a clock face. Okay, I want you to hold on to my clock face. I also have an arrow. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to ask you to select one of the times on the clock face, and I'm going to see if I can make this arrow stop on that time. Is that fair enough?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Now, you notice that there's nothing connected to this, so there are no motors or anything like that. I'm going to just spin this around, okay? And while it's spinning, you tell me what time.
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. Watch real carefully. It's slowing down, and it's stopping on 9 o'clock.
Wow. You really are the greatest magician. Bye, Mike.
Bye.
Yuck!
So this little new girl is a bully, and she's trying to pull one over on Mike. Yeah, I'm the only one that's allowed to do that. Oh, and I've got to keep my eye on this girl, because she could be my competition. Oh, right, Clark. And if I'm not careful, she will be the one handing out granola snake cans. Arr!
Okay, everybody. Hold both of your legs out like this and count for five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good, now let's try it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect.
Hi, girls and boys. Today, I'm gonna show you that eggs are a lot stronger than you think, because I'm gonna stand on some eggs without breaking them. Eggs are amazing, and of course they have this hard protective shell that's a lot stronger than you realize. If you take an egg in your hand and you squeeze it and you wanna apply even pressure, you'll realize that an egg can actually withstand a lot of force. Now the other thing I need to caution you about is that anytime you touch a raw egg, you want to then thoroughly wash your hands, because sometimes there can be bacteria on the shell, which can make you really sick. Okay, so now watch what happens when I stand on these cartons of eggs. But before I do that, I want to point out something about an egg. When you look at an egg, usually one end is a little bit more pointed than the other end. So what I've done is I've aligned all the eggs in the carton so the pointed end is up. And then the other thing to notice is I have a garbage bag on the floor, because if this experiment doesn't work, it's a disaster. So you want to make sure that you protect the floor. Okay, so here I go. Now I'm going to stand on this carton of eggs and watch what happens. Hopefully I won't break any. There's one foot. There's the other foot. Look at that. I'm standing on the cartons of eggs. Isn't that incredible? And they're not breaking. I weigh almost 200 pounds, and they're not breaking. This is amazing. So what's going on? Well, it all has to do with the shape of the egg. You see, the egg's shape is unique, and it's very similar to a three-dimensional arch, which is one of the strongest architectural features known. The other thing about an egg is the strongest parts of the shell are at the top and the bottom of the egg. So when you put pressure on the top and bottom, it's less likely to break. And then finally, the curvature of the shell helps evenly distribute the pressure on the egg. So boys and girls, this is a great experiment to do at home to impress your friends. But make sure you ask your parents before you do this experiment and get their permission. And make sure you cover the floor, because if it doesn't work, you're gonna have a mess.
Remember, boys and girls, if you want to learn more about science, just go to our website. And remember, it looks like magic, but it's science.
Why are we in Daisy's garden shop?
We told you. We're trying to stay away from Grace, the new girl at school.
I'm afraid of her. She keeps pushing me around.
It sounds like she is a bully.
You could say that again. She keeps yelling at me and calling me names.
That's not right.
We know, but what do we do?
Well, I remember when I was afraid of Nastini. I thought that he was a bully. Salty said I had to stand up to him.
And did you?
Well, you see, that is, Oh, look, it's Daisy.
Oh, hi, guys.
Hi, Daisy.
What's up?
There's a new girl at school, and she's bullying Morgan, Kate, and Emma.
What? That's awful. Have you told anybody about this?
Well, not exactly. I'm afraid she'll hurt me if I say anything.
It's like she's mad at the world.
I told them that they have to stand up to the bully.
We need to figure out a way to stop this bad behavior.
But what can we do?
I haven't slept well for days worrying about this.
And I haven't felt like eating either.
Well, let's tell Mike. I'm sure he'll know what to do.
Great idea. I think I'll go talk to Joey too. Bye.
Bye, Max.
I feel better already. We shouldn't have let an adult know what was going on right away.
Exactly.
Suddenly, I'm hungry.
Do you want a banana?
What?
Do you know why the apple and orange were all alone?
No. Why?
Because the banana split!
Oh, no. All right, you guys, let's go to the kitchen and make a healthy snack, and then we'll go talk to Mike.
Let's go!
Come on.
It's time for a healthy snack!
What are we gonna make today, Daisy?
Well, I thought we could use some magic around here, so why don't we make edible magic wands?
Wow, a wand you could eat?
That's right.
Oh boy, that sounds like fun.
Well, they're really easy to make. Let me show you how to do it. You take a pretzel stick and you smear on low-fat peanut butter, just like this. Then you take the stick and you roll it into chopped nuts. And there you have edible magic wands. You guys want to try?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Wow, this is easy, Daisy. Looks delicious.
Yeah, they only have 98 calories, 2 grams of fat, and 1 gram of sugar.
Let's eat.
Right.
It's time for a quick trick. Daisy, I have 3 cards. I have a king, a queen, and the 3 of hearts. Okay. I'm going to take those cards and I'm going to mix them up a little bit.
Okay.
I'm going to take one of the cards and place it down here. I'm actually going to show you the other 2, the king and the queen. So what card do I have left over here?
It's the 3 of hearts.
Well, you're close. It's the 3 of hearts.
What?
Can you do that? Sure you can. I'll show you how after this.
Today's quick trick is brought to you by the sweet potato. The sweet potato is a root vegetable and tastes much sweeter than the common potato. Sweet potatoes can have flesh and skins that are yellow, orange, pink, or deep purple. There are about 400 varieties of sweet potatoes to choose from. Sweet potatoes are native to Central America and are one of the oldest vegetables known to man. Christopher Columbus brought sweet potatoes to Europe after his first voyage to the New World in 1492. They were brought to the United States around the 16th century.
Sweet potatoes are very high in beta carotene. They also are an excellent source of vitamin A, vitamin C, and manganese. Try some sweet potatoes today before they're all gone.
Enjoy a sweet potato for dinner tonight. You'll love them like I do.
Now here's the quick trick secret. You actually have a very special card. It's called a flap card. You see, it's part of a 3 of heart, and it's attached to the king. So to do that, take an old deck of playing cards from Mom or Dad and cut the three in hearts in half. If you're not allowed to use the scissors, ask an adult to help. Then take that half of a three of heart and glue it to the king. Or use some tape, like I'm doing. There we go. Now you have a flap card. And I've already done that here. Then go to our website and print out the tree of hearts. Take the tree of hearts and place it underneath the flap, like that. Then take another card and cover the tree of hearts. So now you have the king, the queen, and the three of hearts. Okay. Looks like there's three cards, but actually there's four. Now, show that to your friends and tell them that you have a three of hearts in the center. Turn it over. They still think you have three cards and that the center one is the three of hearts. Actually, it's the tree of hearts. Now, when you separate them, take the tree of hearts, place it on the table, and then slide the queen closer to the king, hiding the flap. Now, when you show it to your friends, you show them that you only have two cards. Ask them what card's on the table.
Three of hearts.
You say, well, that was close. And then you show them the tree of hearts. And that's the quick trick secret. For more quick tricks, be sure to check out our website. In the meantime, try this one at home and you'll have some fun.
There's a new girl at school, Grace, and she is bullying Morgan, Kate, and Emma.
That's terrible.
I wonder what we should do.
Yeah, we have to do something. I just hate having competition.
I was hoping that you might have an idea about how to stop her from being a bully, Joey.
There's that please and thank you machine. I just can't bring myself to say those words.
Hey, wait a minute. Maybe we can use Pat to teach this bully a lesson.
That's it. Great thinking, Professor. Hey, here's my idea. Come closer. Look, we'll use Pat and Nastini. And Nastini.
That's
we'll
a great idea.
And that's the story, Mike.
Well, I wondered why you girls look so upset. You know, the new girl on the block seemed a little strange.
What do we do about a bully, Mike? Yes, Salty. The new girl at school is yelling at me and trying to scare me.
What? Why, I'll grab her and make her walk the plank!
I wish that was the answer, Salty, but I'm afraid not.
Just let Bob Four Apples get a hold of her. Oh, I'll show her a bully.
No, Salty. Bullying her won't make it right.
Well, then what are we supposed to do?
There are some very important things that we can all do to prevent bullying. First, we need to be more than a bystander. That means you have to be involved and not just stand by.
And don't give bullying an audience. That means don't laugh along when someone else is getting bullied.
Help keep ye friends safe. Get your friends away from the bully, tell the bully to stop, and then find a trusted adult. Right away.
And don't ever bully somebody else.
You know, bullies come in all sizes and shapes. Other children, but adults too.
And don't forget, there's also cyberbullies.
These are all good lessons when you have to deal with a bully.
You know, I had to deal with a bully when I was a small boy.
You did?
Yes. And its story's a little different, so let me tell it to you. Whenever I'd walk to school, a bully would come up behind me. And he'd push me, and he'd knock me over, and he'd make fun of me. Well, one day I was walking to school and I saw the bully, and I decided I wasn't going to take any more of this. So we had a schoolhouse. I want you to see the schoolhouse. It's empty. And I decided I was going to run inside to the schoolhouse, climb up all the steps, and come out on the roof. Well, the bully saw me up on the roof, and he said, come on down. And I said, no way.
The bully said, well, then I'm going to come up and get you. And so the bully ran into the schoolhouse. Well, when the bully did that, I decided to say the magic words, abracadabra. And I began to grow and grow and grow and grow until I was taller than the schoolhouse.
Wow.
That's the way to deal with a bully.
So the bully, can you imagine when he came out of the roof and he saw me? He got so scared that he ran back inside the schoolhouse. Well, I said the magic words again, abracadabra. And as the bully ran down the steps, he got smaller and smaller and smaller. So by the time the bully came out of the schoolhouse, he was very small. Well, he saw how tall I was, and he got so scared, he ran away, and he never bullied me again or anyone else. Now, I know that you can't say the magic words and make yourself taller than the school, but if you and your friends and the surrounding adults face up to this bully, then the bully will think that you're this tall, and he or she will shrink down, and you'll never be bothered again with the bully. And that's the story of my bully.
Well, that was a great trick, Mike. Wow.
As I said, that's the way to deal with a bully.
That's right. Don't just be a bystander.
Don't stand by when someone's bullied. Don't laugh or play along.
Don't stand by when someone's bullied. Step up and say,
show we disapprove in the way that we respond. If nobody participates, a bully won't be strong.
Don't stand by when someone's bullied with violence or insults.
Don't stand by when someone's bullied. I know it's difficult.
Find someone in authority that you can consult. Tell a parent, a teacher, or another trusted adult.
Don't stand by when someone's bullied.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, Max. Max.
We have a plan for the bully.
Yeah, we're going to use that.
Yeah, this infernal machine? Oh, I mean this perfectly lovely device?
What are we going to do?
Well, here's my idea. Come gather around.
Nice.
What
we can
do is this.
You can do it. This is a great trick.
Give me that.
I want it.
I thought you said you didn't like magic tricks. What business is it of yours?
Hey, stop that.
Stop being a bully, Grace.
Who's gonna stop me? A weakling like you?
No, but we'll all stop you together.
What?
Look, it's Nastini with the please and thank you machine.
What's that?
It's a machine that gives you anything you ask for.
I don't believe it.
If you don't believe, then watch.
Yeah, please give me some popcorn.
Of course.
Thank you.
Give me that. I want to try.
Yay. You better be careful with that little girl.
Oh, shut up. Oh, boy. I love popcorn. Give me lots and lots of popcorn.
Don't you want to say please?
Oh, just shut up and give it to me.
I hate bullies.
Look, it's working.
She's getting popcorn dumped all over her.
Come on, we better get in there.
Help, help, help.
Look who looks bad now. Here, have some more popcorn.
Wait, you guys. Let's not become bullies ourselves.
Nax is right.
Are you okay?
You mean, you guys aren't gonna make fun of me?
No, Grace, we want to be your friend.
Maybe I was wrong about all of you. I was just so mad about having to move and leave all my friends. I guess I took it out on you.
It's not easy moving to a new place and having to start over again making new friends.
That's for sure.
I like to be friends with all of you.
Yuck! Yeah, I'm out of here.
What's wrong with him?
It's a long story.
Come on, let's go get you cleaned up.
Mike, I really did like your magic.
Well, you're welcome to come watch magic anytime.
Really?
Yes.
Bye!
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 Bye-bye!
Well, what a day.
Yes, Joey. What are you going to put in your journal today?
Today, I learned how to handle a bully.
That's really important. You know, bullies come in all ages and sizes.
Other children, teens, and adults.
And don't forget about cyberbullies on the internet.
Oh yeah, it's also very important not to just be a bystander.
Don't give bullying an audience. Stand up to a bully with an adult close by. Help people who are being bullied get away. Tell a trusted adult about a bully. Set a good example, don't bully others. And be a good friend.
Remember, no one deserves to be bullied.
That's right. Say goodbye, Jelly.
Bye, everyone. Thank you for being my friend.
And remember, boys and girls, the real magic is in you. Stay safe. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
So, yuck! And then you look. Maybe take one of these. And then grab it.
Okay.
And then go.
Right, Clark! And you know...
Okay, just a second.
You mean you're not gonna make fun of me?
I'm not getting out of this.
Oh no!
Abracadabra is a production of the West Virginia School of Osteopathic Medicine and its Healthy Children's Initiative, working for a healthier West Virginia. Additional funding for this program is provided by Charleston Area Medical Center, the heart and soul of healthcare. Learn more about our 5210 campaign to keep kids healthy on the web at camc.org/kids. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield West Virginia, offering affordable insurance products for all your needs. Find the right coverage for you. Visit highmarkbcbswv.com. We've got you covered. West Virginia Mutual Insurance Company, working every day with physicians and the entire healthcare community to improve public health. For more information, visit us online at wvmic.com. And by the Brick Street Foundation, proud to support local organizations that make a positive difference, helping communities grow to their fullest potential. For more information, visit us online at brickstreetfoundation.org.